Distribution networks, as we know them today, were built primarily for unidirectional power flows. And we see today with integration of renewables, more and more renewables with different loads, modern loads such as e-vehicles on the network, that the network needs to start behaving and needs to be managed as a bi-directional network.
Here in TECNALIA we have a microgrid, which is a facility where we can replicate both generation, renewable generation sources, and also different loading conditions and different network, both topologies and situations.
We are testing and benchmarking primarily two, and this is voltage regulations, so keeping voltage in the regulatory frames, in the regulatory limits. And the second one is what we call predictive capacity management. That means predicting when and what kind of capacity will be available on the network and how to balance the demand and supply.
During the course of the day, the voltage of the electricity flowing through the networks experiences a fluctuation that can, for instance, lead to technical losses or lower the life expectancy of electrical devices. Low peaks often occur at night, when solar panels can't charge up on sunlight or there's no wind to get wind turbines running. On the other hand, as the sun reappears in the morning, or wind starts to pick up again, the networks experience an unhealthy voltage overload. Networks often experience higher peaks, which can break electrical devices like transformers, or lead to flickering when voltage is too low. Landis+Gyr's S650 smart grid terminal measures and monitors these variations and sends the data to Toshiba's microenergy management system in order to automatically analyze the data and control these fluctuations. A range of voltage regulation control mechanisms such as TVR, a battery energy storage system, and RES control bring down the voltage peak significantly and enable the network operators to keep the variations within the regulatory frame at any time.
There are many solutions in the market, but this one particular characteristic of this solution is it fits very well on existing legacy systems, so it helps in the retrofitting on the existing equipment. It also, the control of the micro EMS controller is distributed, so it doesn't rely on communications within the central control systems, and that's very good from the point of view of communication. That makes it cost effective, really cost effective. And also it offers flexibility in terms of the elements that can be controlled.
The solution that Landis+Gyr and Toshiba is providing is something innovative, something new in the spectrum of smart grid offerings. Not only it's actually available for deployment today, but it's also, it allows retrofitting, it allows distributed management of resources in your network.
We saw together with our customer electrically working demonstration, and I think this is the first time we actually have seen a working demonstration in lives.
It's a good way to visualize the problem, to really see what the future holds for us, to see it play out in a simulation makes you understand the complexities of what we face in the future.
We are able to maintain voltage within regulatory limits and also manage the capacity of lines and distribution network assets.